But if someone's sitting here today and they've not seen the passion, or they haven't had that God encounter the way that you have, what would be the one parting thing that you'd like for them to know about your life and the God relationship and how they need to connect with God?
So you ask me this, so I will tell you what I know God wants me to say.
Sure.
For one, I love you. I love you. That's what you want to hear, isn't it? Number two, you are all going to heaven. And you say, how do you know this? It's very simple. God had been in your heart a long time. He's been dormant, some of you. Some of you, much more alive. But continually, God is asking for more conversion. I will tell you how I know that God loves you this much, and how I know that you're all going to heaven. Some men here and women are adulterers. Some have committed murder. Some of you didn't have the abortion, but you paid for it, so you have contributed to this. Many people are part of this great sin in this country. Over 50 million in the United States alone. 45 million die every year in the world. These are all God's children, and God brings them home. Now He wants to bring you home. Now, in this moment, this is a chance for heaven right now. You don't have to wait to die to experience heaven. Did you go to one of your friends and ask your friend, hear my story? And you say, yes, I went to one person. I said, why do you go to this person to confide in this sin to them? Because they didn't judge me. Because they loved me. Because I felt mercy and grace. Now, I ask you this. Do you think that your God doesn't have more mercy than your friend? Do you think your friend has more grace than God? Does your friend have more love than the Creator? It can never be. It can never be. So, God forgives you. And now He needs you to begin again. To accept forgiveness. Earlier I said, God never sends a man into hell. People choose this place. Your choice. God made you and loves you. There's never been another like you. So He's coming to you now. Right now, in this moment. All He has to hear from you is yes. Yes, you've accepted Jesus, some of you. Keep accepting Him. Every time we sin, we deny Him. Be holy. Be perfect, just as my Father is perfect. My commandment to you is this. You love one another just as I have loved you. Your name may not appear down here in this world's Hall of Fame. In fact, you may be so unknown that no one knows your name. The Oscars and the praise of men may never come your way, but don't forget, God has rewards that He'll hand out someday. This crowd on earth, they will soon forget when you're not at the top. They will cheer like mad until you fall, and then their praise will stop. Not God, He never does forget, and in His Hall of Fame, by just believing on His Son, forever there's your name. I tell you, friend, I wouldn't trade my name, however small, that's written there beyond the stars in that celestial hall, for all the famous names on earth, for the glory that they share. I'd rather be an unknown here and have my name up there. God bless you.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
I love you.